Hi guys, welcome back to YouTube channel Foundation Chemistry AB. So today we'll talk about the study of Bunsen burner. So this will be highly beneficial for 11th and 12th class students. So I have a simple message for you. Please think for innovation, be creative, learn everywhere, anytime, and help to learn others. So many chemical reactions require heating. So in chemistry laboratory, Bunsen burner is an essential requirement or instrument. So the aim of the experiment is to study different parts of a Bunsen burner and its flame. So you can see here the nice Bunsen burner. So this is the way how it looks like. And if you connect to it to the gas and put the matchstick or lighter on, you will get the flame like this. So the different parts of Bunsen burners are base, nipple, or you can call it jet, burner tube, and air regulator, or you can call it cooler. So what is a base? So it is made up of a cast iron and it gives stability to the burner. So you can see this blue portion, that is the called the base. And it has a side tube which is connected to gas cylinder. The next is nipple or jet. It is made up of brass and it is connected to the base of the burner. There is a pin hole in the jet through which the gas comes out with pressure. Then this one, the long tube, is burner tube. It is a metallic tube fitted on the base of the burner, keeping the jet inside. Just above the jet, there is a hole on the burner tube called air hole. Next is air regulator. So it is a small metallic ring having two holes on opposite sides. It is fitted around the burner tube so that by rotating it, the air holes of the burner tube may be closed or open as desired. Now we will talk about flame of Bunsen burner. So when you light the burner, you will get a flame like this. So in Bunsen burner, two types of flames are produced, such as luminous and non-luminous flame. So luminous flame, a yellow sooty flame is produced when the air hole of the burner tube is closed. So you can see here the yellow sooty flame. It is called a luminous flame. So due to insufficient supply of oxygen, incomplete combustion of gas takes place, and as a result, unburnt carbon particles are present in the flame. And the carbon particles help for reduction of any substance. So the luminous flame is also called reducing flame. So next is non-luminous flame. So this type of flame is produced when air hole of the burner tube is completely open. In this type of flame, complete combustion of gas takes place, and so the flame does not contain carbon particles. It is also known as oxidizing flame. Next is parts of luminous flame. So luminous flame has four parts, such as blue zone, zone of no combustion, zone of incomplete combustion, and zone of complete combustion. So you can see the blue part here just above the burner tube, and you can also see the outermost zone. Okay, so that is called zone of complete combustion. And inside this blue zone and outermost zone, you have two zones, zone of no combustion and zone of incomplete combustion. So blue zone is the base of luminous flame, and it contains carbon monoxide. So you can see here that blue zone. And just above blue zone, there is dark inner zone where combustion does not take place. So it is also known as zone of no combustion. And above that, zone of incomplete combustion is present, which contains unburnt carbon particles. So the outermost zone is called zone of complete combustion. So you can see the Bunsen burner. You can see the outer periphery of the flame. Then parts of non-luminous flame. Non-luminous flame has two parts, such as innermost blue zone and outermost zone. So the innermost zone, blue zone, is at the top of the burner tube, and the temperature of this zone is low and it contains unburnt gas. And the outer zone is the hot oxidizing zone, and the temperature of this zone is quite high. So in conclusion, we have discussed here in detail about the Bunsen burner and the types of flame. So I will be happy if you guys subscribe to our channel Foundation Chemistry AB. So this will be also available in the website www.foundationchemistryab.com. So this is a simple step towards e-learning, making life better. So thank you all for learning.